today is a significant day, obviously, because we've got so many people coming through to get vaccinated with the scare of Omicron. Can you tell me more about that?
Oh, look, we've extended our services from 6 a.m. to 6:30 p.m. And that's because we're not in lockdown anymore, and we've got a lot of people that work. And so we've got to try and deliver services fit for the community as opposed to fit for the provider of the service. So that's why we've extended services, and we've got 4 mobiles out there at the moment. So we're just trying to make access to vaccination opportunities as open as possible for as many people as possible. And remember, we've got our babies under 12 now. So just got to make it as comfortable for a whole whānau to come in, one for boosters, and bring the babies.
Your establishment has been have had a raumati break, obviously. What's the response been like now that you're back in business and vaccinations and testing?
All of our social platforms, big responses. And as you can see today, it's picking up, and it'll start to peak over the next 3 or 4 weeks, just before start of school. Most schools back on February the 6th or thereabouts, just after Waitangi Day. And so we're hoping to work our way through there too for those under 12s.
Now, obviously there's so many tamariki getting vaccinated. There are some whānau obviously that have their own views, but I'd like to actually cover the Māori vaccination data again with you. Last month the High Court had ruled that the Ministry would not be releasing any information when it comes to second time vaccinations for those that haven't yet got theirs. I mean, how much of a challenge is that for the whānau Waipareira and any other whānau order agency?
No, we won 2 High Court cases, and so we've got access to all the parents' data. And that is merely to offer a vaccine opportunity, not to beat them up over not taking a vaccine. Our biggest problem is that we're dealing with health authorities, with Mr. Bloomfield and co, that just deny us and resist our access. If we've got access to the parents, we should have access to the children. You'd think it would follow. And so if we have to go back to court again, so be it. But you know, it's bizarre to believe that you can have access to the data of the parents but are blocked from access to the data of their babies. It just doesn't follow. So you try and work that one out, and what's going to have to happen is that someone in charge of government is going to have to take control of this process. Yeah, we're over it.
I just want to get my understanding around this. So the Ministry has given Ministry requirement to consult with iwi to release any of their data out. Is that correct?
No. The privacy issues around data, and no iwi warlord, my cousin included, that controls Naatis, owns me and my data. About 2,500 Naatis live at home. The other 77,000 live in areas like this. So to suggest that someone in Whangarei or someone in Ruatoria has a say over a herd called Naatis is just not true. It's a bit like saying the Pope has a say over me as a Catholic. Just not true.
Interesting. When is the next court hearing?
We'll know that pretty soon in terms of how we're riding with our baby's vaccination program. And then if we have to take litigation, so be it. But basically, it's now political rather than legal. So you'd have to ask the Prime Minister why we can get access to our adults, but we're denied access to our children. Pretty simple question.
Very good. What would it look like if it was under the Māori Health Authority, obviously, that's going to be established sometime this year? Would that make things a lot more easier in terms of releasing data of all ages?
Oh, look, it's a game changer. The Māori Health Authority frees us from being treated as second-class citizens, frees us to actually be innovative, to use our own resources in our own way. See right now today, I've got 6 kids, right, and 10 mokopuna. So out of that, we've got 18 people in my immediate whānau, including myself and wife. We're worth $400 each on a capitation to the GP clinic. If I use that money for health insurance, I wouldn't need Bloomfield. I wouldn't need anybody else. But somebody else is taking my money and spending it for me, and I don't know where it's going. So that's unacceptable. So the Māori Health Authority will change that completely, and I'm really happy about that.